Hi, I'm Carla Adams. I'll be reading from my book, Ancestral River, A Spiritual Journey for the Living and the Dead. This is Chapter 9, Trauma. Sadness flooded over me as I received a biofield session. The practitioner was stuck in a pocket of energy from when I had felt fat and out of control at age 10. In a vision, I saw my younger self curled in a fetal position in the dark. She was crying too. I said to her, "I'm so sorry I rejected you. I want you with me forever." She uncurled and climbed out of the darkness and into my heart. We became one. A few days later, fear overwhelmed me. I placed my attention into it and suddenly was in a vision. I felt the fear of being unwanted and unworthy that I had felt in the womb. Then I felt my old thought pattern wanting to be in charge. "You're bad. I need to fix you." Fear rose again. Taking a deep breath, I held the baby with my heart. "I love you so much. Please trust me. Give me your fear." Smiling, she climbed into my lap, then into my central energy channel. I said, "Thank you for trusting me. Thank you for letting me love you now." In another session a few weeks later, the practitioner said, "In this stuck energy, you're 3 years old and feeling terror." I said, "I don't remember anything that would have caused terror at that age. I don't feel any emotions right now." She said, "In my experience, people who have blocked out memories of sexual trauma from when they were young usually have body image problems by the age of 10 and have eating disorders in their teenage years." The first thought that came to mind was a memory I was ashamed of. I said, "When I was a child, I often played with my Barbie doll behind a large chair in the corner of the dining room where no one could see me. I'd take off her clothes and place her on a little table. The two boy dolls would laugh at her and rub their hands between her legs. I never knew how I learned to play that way, but I always felt guilty for it." That night, I said to Universal Spirit, "Please give me a memory." 2 days later, I was in a vision. I was little, wearing a dress and lying on a table. A man stood at my right side wearing dark pants and a white shirt. His face looked familiar. Somehow I knew his wife was aware of what he was doing, but she wasn't there. A half-grown boy stood at my left knee. Weeks later, as a practitioner worked in my biofield, anger ripped through me. When her fork sounded dissonant in the ancestral flow on my right side, I said, "I hear the man from my 3-year-old terror. He's sad the little girl was scared, but he doesn't regret what he did." My father and all my grandfathers in the first 4 generations had already transitioned to the oneness. I didn't have a father figure other than my dad. This man must have been a father figure to dad. The practitioner said, "For this session, we held the intention to help your relationship with money. Maybe the man gave you money." I was still angry, but knowing that if my life had been different, I may not be connecting deeply with Universal Spirit and having the experiences I am now, I said to the man, "Thank you for what you did." He asked, "Do you mean it?" Part of me did. The next week I said to a friend, "I haven't done hypnosis before. I'm nervous." He said, "Nothing can happen that you don't want to happen. Let's do a practice session so you can feel more comfortable with the process." He walked me down a stairway and into the sunshine, then to a tree near a stream. The tree said, "Sit." The grass said, "Take off your shoes and feel the ground." My spirit was part of the ground. Then I was the tree. It was the cottonwood tree that had been cut down when I was young. Seeing the tree lying in the dirt that day had broken my heart. I had played in its shade, hopscotch, hide-and-seek, tag. My young arms had not been able to reach around it, but I had placed my hands on its trunk and talked to it. It had been my friend. Being near the tree again made me feel safe and comforted. "Tree, do you have a name?" I asked. "No, I am." As my friend guided me, I looked for angels, ancestors, or animals, but I only saw the tree, the light, and me. "Tree, will you go with me on my journey?" The tree said, "No, the light is all you need." So I asked, "Light, will you show me your heart?" "You are my heart." I climbed into a small travel pod. It landed on a beautiful beach. The water held crystals and dolphins that healed people. Floating through the water, surrounded by light, I spoke with the dolphins without words, touching them softly. Soon I returned to the bottom of the stairway. The tree, light, and water had felt so safe. I wasn't ready for the uncertainty of the world. "Tree, will you come with me?" "No, you have all you need inside you." In my next hypnosis session, I was 3 years old, standing in the dining room of the farmhouse I grew up in. The wood floors and dinner table were dusted with the light pouring in through tall windows. I walked across the gray-tiled kitchen floor, out the back porch door, and down the wooden steps to my cottonwood tree. I rode in the back seat of a car for a long time. My conscious mind recognized the man who walked up to the car. My family had visited him several times when I was growing up. As my parents went into the house with his wife, the man turned to me, speaking softly. "You're so pretty. Come with me." My bare feet walked through the grass to a building. He opened the door. He placed me on a table and stood at my right side. I felt his hands under my dress, the tip of his finger inserted between my legs. He looked toward the door. "Boy, come here." A half-grown boy entered the room and stood at my left side. He said to the man, "You shouldn't be doing that. It's wrong." The man looked at the floor. "I know." He helped me off the table and gave me a coin. "Go buy some candy." In the yard, my big brother came running. He was almost 5. "I heard you crying and wanted to help, but the door was locked. Are you okay?" We walked to the house. Mommy and Daddy were there with my baby sister and the man's wife. In my conscious mind, there flashed scenes of when I had tried to be good to please Dad. The smiles of love on my parents' faces told me they had no idea that anything had happened. But the woman was angry. She knew, but said nothing. Hypnosis helped me understand the source of some of my old emotional reactions and thought patterns, but I needed acknowledgement of my pain. The man and his wife died 30 years ago. All I have are pockets in my biofield, memories of my Barbie doll, a vague vision, and hypnosis. I doubt my family would believe me. I wrote a letter to the man's son and mentioned very few details, pretending that I didn't know what had happened and wanted his help to remember. As I slipped the envelope into the mail, I felt some of my ancestors in the oneness. They said, "Thank you for writing the letter." Weeks later, I awoke during the night, still in bed. My head turned to the west. Roads and terrain passed as I traveled. Knowing Universal Spirit was taking me to the son's house, I sent him love and support. The front room of his home was bright. Pictures hung on the walls. He entered the room and wrote something on a piece of paper, wadded it up, and tossed it onto a pile in the wastebasket by his chair. Silently, I said, "Write it all down. Let it all flow." Intuition led me to a bookshelf. A manila envelope was in the middle of a tall stack of paper. Trying not to topple the stack, I tugged gently until the envelope was in my hands. It was 9 by 12 inches. "He won't want this. It's so much bigger than he needs." His back was to me, But his thoughts said, "Yes, I'll use it." I laid the envelope where he could find it and stood with my arm around his shoulders as he wrote, sending him thanks. Processing my emotions of trauma took months, especially my feelings about money. I needed more information. In another hypnosis session, I was on the table. The man reached into his pocket, then extended his arm toward me. I could hardly see the coin pinched between his finger and thumb. He said, "Never tell anyone or you'll be a bad girl." The trauma had affected how I felt about my body, food, sex, relationships, and money. It brought distrust, unworthiness, fear of being rejected, and fear of speaking my truth. Anger, hate, sadness, and feeling unworthy had become anchored in my mind and in the muscles of my shoulders and back. Emotions cleared a bit every day as I focused on where I felt them in my body. Yoga, massage, biofield sessions, crying, screaming, talking with my husband, and journaling helped. As a three-year-old, my formative mind had said, "You're a victim. This vibration means you can't change what happens to you. You can't change how you feel about it." Powerlessness was the lens through which I had viewed life. But having read that the vibrations of fear were similar to the vibrations of excitement, as I cleared emotions caused by trauma, I chose to feel my fear as excitement to help me step into my power, take action, and create the life I wanted. In meditation, Universal Spirit took me inside my body to the vaginal opening. Feeling the old trauma, I said to those muscles, "Release. Forgive." Suddenly, in a vision, I was 3 years old. I said to the man as he touched me, "Stop it. You have no right to do this. Take your hands off me." Then I forgave him. And I forgave his son for not being able to stop him. And I forgave my brother for not being able to help me. And I said, "We're going into the house to tell Dad and Mom." Still in the vision, I told my parents what had happened. My brother spoke also, and the son nodded in agreement. The man hung his head. I forgave my father for not protecting me. Then I forgave my mother for not comforting me. As I released the feelings buried 60 years ago, gratitude for my family filled my heart. Weeks later, in meditation with Universal Spirit, my feelings of love and joy drained away and tingles spread across my body. The man was standing next to me. Anger boiled up. "Why did you hurt me? I hate you. I was just a little girl. You made me feel pain all my life." His vibration held sadness for the little girl who had been scared, but not sorrow for his actions. But without his actions, I wouldn't be experiencing the wonders of the universe or feeling the wonderful changes within me that I am now. Thank you for what you did.
Really?
Yes. He moved to the vortex. "I want to transition." "You need to let your son know you want his help," I said. He said, "I'm ready for the oneness." "No," I thought, "he's avoiding his son." "But maybe he can." "You're welcome to try," I told him. He stayed in the vortex, wiggling, a vibration of frustration building. I said, "Maybe you need to clear your heart." He turned away into the waiting place.